la serie alquímica.
Kevin is preparing the raw material for his new sculpture. The artist already holds credit for several monuments in Kenya. But instead of clay, he uses a softer, synthetic material called plasticine. He says after long research, he decided that this method allows him greater room for movements.
I'm actually forced to use plasticine because it doesn't dry and it gives you time. You can work on plasticine even the whole year. You change this, you change that, without actually getting scared that either the piece will be dry and you can't manipulate. So that is why I now picked on that media.
But the process requires Kevin to train young sculptors to help him. And he gets the assistance he needs here, at Nairobi's Kiona Artists Collective Center for Visual Arts.
Over the years, I've trained a few guys, and the people have trained always then when I have excess work, I have to call them in. So it's not about employing anybody. It's about when I need them, I have to call them.
The Kiona Trust was launched in 1995 as a space for Kenyan artists to develop their skills through collaboration. One of those artists is Meshack Oiro, who specializes in sculpting human and animal forms.
My media is metal, but then I also use junk. Junk in terms of any metal which have been discarded and thrown away. I pick those and use them. I work from Kiona Art Collective, and the reason why I chose to work from this space particularly is because I have enough room to do my practice, and then it's more central.
This is about the space.
Elizabeth was previously living in the United States, but returned to Kenya to just join the Kiona Artists Collective. She says the center gives Kenyan artists a chance to promote their work.
I feel Kiona has taught me how the artistic world is in Nairobi. I feel like Kiona has introduced me to galleries that they have in their guest list. They've introduced me to different artists that I could work with in the field, yeah? And as someone who's come back home from being abroad, that's really important because you don't have many connections.
The Kiona Artists Collective is managed and funded by the artists themselves. For now, money doesn't seem to be much of a problem. The main challenge for these artists is that their work is seldom appreciated by the public due to a lack of art education at Kenya's schools.